Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's a Philips GM6012 wideband millivoltmeter. Yeah, it covers from 1 millivolt and all the way to 300 volts. And you can select the different frequency ranges. From 2 Hz to 1 MHz or 10 Hz to 1 MHz. So that is the wide band they talk about, and I guess that will be power off. Sounds like a power on off switch, and there's a broken arrow here on this knob. It was completely yellow and dirty. I spent quite a long time with alcohol cleaning the front so it's a little bit presentable for this video. If you look here on the side, and then you can probably imagine how the front was looking because I didn't clean the sides. We got some more connectors and adjustments here on the side. And this thing is an all-tube device. I think it is 9 tubes, and there are only 4 diodes. Those are tiny little signal diodes for the meter, so that's a bridge rectifier for the meter, and that's it. The rest is done completely using tubes. It's almost 10 kilos, and it is huge. Oh man, this is heavy. I think I will be able to put it down like this so you can see the rear panel. And yes, the 55 watts is what they say. Oh, look at that mains power entry. Yeah, I'm sure I got the connector for this. But I just can't power this up yet because I need to figure out what is the loose part in this one. Because when I move it around like this, I can hear some loose parts rattling around in here. So we need to open first. So that is the first look inside. And I don't see any broken tubes or anything. I think this is really cute. Look at that. So it's hanging in springs. And the first inspection looks like we are quite happy about what we see here. I still haven't found. Yes, I found what I was looking for down here. Here's a little black piece of something. And what is that? Is that a... that is the manual or something. A photocopy of the manual. Isn't that cute? Ha! Really? Okay. I'm quite happy about that. And it is in a quite good quality. Look, if I go real close, all the tiny little details there here. I can really read the schematic in super good quality. This is better compared to what I was able to find online. So yeah, that was some luck. So that means this is the little loose part. Oops. That is the backside of a pot meter. So where is that pot? I mean, I need to completely dissect this unit to get in there, I guess. Oh, voltage regulator. Ooh, there's also quite a lot of dust and funny things on that capacitor. The transformer will be in here. Yes. I will figure this out. So now I've removed all the side panels, so I got plenty of access all the way around this unit. And there is a little secret trick to removal of all side panels. So of course you remove the two screws, or the screws here from the back to all the different of the four side panels, but then it can't get out. You need to push it towards the front, then it goes down, and then you can pull it out, because there's a groove up here all the way around that holds all the side panels. So this also applies to the sides and the top and all that stuff. And if you don't know this trick, it's impossible to figure out how to disassemble this unit. It's also really good explained in the manual, so good I got that one. So this is of course the amplifier. I really find it funny that it is hanging in springs, but tubes are sensitive to mechanical movement, or if there's any hum or vibrations in the chassis or in your desk for whatever reason, you don't want this to affect all the tubes. So this is a high gain amplification stage. So let's look here in the bottom. We got all the different switch sections for all the different ranges. It is really beautifully made. There's only a little bit of loose hairs on that one. And okay, yeah, mains entry quite close to, ooh, that one is loose. Is that supposed to be that loose, really? Yeah, well, maybe it is, I don't know. It seems to be okay. That looks like a high precision resistor. And that is the back of that pot. I found this this little piece of plastic earlier, so that is where it's from. And it seems like that pot is not broken from that damage. So hopefully I should be able to power this up and get it up and running. Within a few minutes we should be able to do that. I mean, it looks a little bit crusty and a little bit, I don't know. Maybe it's gonna blow up or take the fuses and we're gonna see smoke and all good things. Or maybe it works, I don't know. Look at that. Dirty, dirty. Ugh. It's super slimy and sticky. Somebody had this in a dirty, dirty shed for 25 years. Look at that. Oy, 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 oy. You can almost imagine how this is gonna smell when I heat up the tubes. Ooh, special quality. I didn't clean this tube yet. But special quality tube got gold plated pins. I don't know if you can see this on the video here, but they are very corroded as well. So this can't be good for contacts. And I think normally you're supposed to use gold plated sockets as well, and they kind of did not do that. So I don't know if this is a standard tube for this unit. I will have a little look here before I power it up, just to show you how well this actually cleans off. With a little bit of water and a little bit of rubbing, you can clean this all nice and shiny again. See here the difference? This one I didn't clean. And here I try to clean it a little bit. So yeah, you can make this nice and shine. And normally I don't recommend touching tubes at all, actually, because some of them, the text on the tubes, it will just go off at the first tiny little touch. And that is also the case with most of the tubes here, except for the special quality one. That is some different kind of ink they used. So that will stay here, even if you clean it. But if you just touch the other ones with your fingers or just try and pull it out, touching the text, it's just going to go away immediately. So if this happens for you, of course, continue to clean them nice and shiny. But then, of course, use a permanent marker and write the number on the tube. This way, it will be easier for you later on. So now I'm done with the first clean, and I think it looks a lot better. At least it's not going to be so smelly when I power it up, because all the very hot tubes, they will definitely stink if they're covered in a thick layer of old gross dust and sticky slime. So yeah, also I cleaned the top of the cap here. That, I guess, is a high voltage point, so that we need to have cleaned. And I brushed all the PCBs, and I think we are ready to power up and see what happens. So let's do it. Let's crank on the mains. And nothing happens, and we dial this 0 watts, 50 watts. Thirty watts. We got lamp. Haha. Let's turn on. I think I am in 1 volt, and this will be RMS. Here it is. Nope. You heard the beep. We got input and 55 watts. And maybe it's still in the warm-up process. It goes up and down 48 volts. Uh-huh. This has a little bit... This changes how many watts it's consuming. Is that really so? 40... Yeah, it goes up. Yes, indeed it does. We're 52 watts in the most sensitive range. And then it's 50. And then here, yeah, 47. 46. 45. I mean, there's definitely something that is going on here. But we still have no reading. So, we're gonna go and do a little bit of debugging. Let's see if we got... light in all the lamps here. Yeah, that one is shiny. Let's turn off the light here. Well, that's me who's making light. That is a good sign. We got some stuff. Good stuff is going on here. Oops, this one I don't see. Then there's another trick. Nope. This one is cold. They're not supposed to be that cold. Oops. I think I found it. It is that easy. Sometimes it is. Let's see. I'm gonna find a new one. Oh, that is actually classic. This whole unit here is what they call for unit C. This is only an oscillator used for calibrations, and we got two output here from this oscillator, so we really don't need this oscillator at all. It is also shown here in the schematic, unit C, just an oscillator for calibrations, nothing more, nothing less. So we don't need that at all. But we got no meter readout, so the trick is I'll go in in the middle, and I will see if I got something, and then I will go left or right depending if I find something or not. It is actually that simple. So let's play. So here we go, first experiment. This one got to be a B4, because they go 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is 1, 2, 3, 4, that one. And that is, of course, the output. No, this is the input side of it. I am measuring. The output is a 500 microfarad. Where the heck is that one? Well, we got plenty of input to that one. So it's maybe that one down here. Yeah, look at that. So this is where I need to look. But anyway, tons of input. Good, good. I just couldn't let this be. So I thought this tube was not working. So an E88CC is just a better and more sexy version of the ECC88. And I just happen to have a bunch of those on stock. So you just plug this one into the PCB and the same thing happened. No filament. And of course the oscillator is not working if there's no filament on the tube. So that is really weird. And if I measure on the back of the PCB, the two tracks that's like deepest down here, right? That is the filament. And I got, what, 6.5 volt AC on those pins on the back of the PCB. But on the front, I get nothing. So this is a broken socket. Really? That is weird. And I, of course, I took the... Let's see if I can show you guys this. See? Of course the tube is working. Yeah. But a broken socket. I've never seen that before, and there isn't any physical sign to show you to show this. I mean, all the pins they are there, and they grab the tube. All the pins, they what? How is this possible? And solderings, they're nice. It annoys me a little bit because I really would like to see this oscillator work. I don't know. Maybe it's time to give up, but I just can't. Of course, there was nothing wrong with this tube. It was just a bad socket. So now I resoldered the socket, poked around with those pins, and I bent them, and I twisted them, and I handled them real bad. So now there's a connection through them, and the lamp is lit, as you can see. So that's good. And, of course, the oscillator is running. Yuppie. So, it's just those things. I need to have this solved, otherwise I can't sleep tonight. Just too bad. I traced. That was, of course, stupid. But anyway, the black and the yellow wire here, that those go directly to the meter. And there is no meter reading at all. So this is the voltage over the meter. So let's try and input my sine wave on the input. I mean, everything here just turns out to be doing its thing. But there's no meter reading. So that means it is inside the meter where the error is, and that is beyond repair, really. But that is the status of this unit, and this is where I think I will leave it for now, and I will put it back for the next 50 years of storage. So thank you for watching. I hope you had fun, and please remember to come back tomorrow.